Hi, I'm Anita. Welcome to Walking Way Overrated, and you're going to hang out mostly with my husband today as he gets to try his first subscription box. Come along and find out what kind.
All right. Craig's birthday is coming up, and we're going to do an unboxing of something that I've never seen before from a place called, what does it say on the edge?
It says Laid Back. Laid Back Snacks.
Yeah, Laid Back Snacks.
Wow, thank you.
Supposed to be healthy.
Thank you, Anita. Wow.
Don't thank me yet. You want to see what's inside.
It's healthy snacks to where you're at. And it's got a tape here that I just need to...
It came like that. No other box around it.
And then...
So we're going to see what's in. And it's healthy. So healthy kind of snack. Because Craig and I have no problem eating unhealthy snacks. So I thought, let's try.
Oh, hello.
And you could set this subscription box to come every second month. I think every third month, every month. Mm. And this comes, I think, with five little snack bags of 140 grams, is it? Per pack.
Hearty Tamari.
That one called that you just took out.
This one is called Hearty Tamari.
Hearty Tamari. And at the bottom it says how much fuel. So this is supposed to be good for, not that Craig mountain climbs or anything. In fact, show us what the lid says, Craig. Turn the box this way. Snacks for the climbs or snacks for the couch. So he's got it for snacks for the couch. Or mine, you might box out of your face. No, you want to show all the flavors. Protein power up.
Yeah.
And they're mostly like nuts. So let's guess what's in there. Ooh, those look like coated cashews.
And Hearty Tamari.
Right.
Okay.
And then, so there's five bags.
Weekend Crunch.
Weekend Crunch. Ooh, it's got those deep fried or baked peas.
Like peas in it.
I like those. A friend from Hong Kong introduced me to that.
Sriracha cashews.
Sriracha.
They're probably spicy.
Yes.
Like the red hot peppers in
so now we want to watch you taste them. So.
Man, it's all...
Oh, what's it say inside?
It's all laid back until someone eats all the snacks.
Okay, so it's a nice little box. And there's a little write-up. Is there a little
everything
slip?
You see is 100% recyclable, not your hands. Those you keep.
Yeah, everything's 100% recyclable.
So
what about...
Enjoy on the box.
And there's a little piece of paper that came with it to describe...
Yeah, that's right.
...about it.
There it is here. And it says... Your snack life just got a whole lot better.
All right.
It says, oh, hello. Laid back snacks.
And it gives you some varieties. You can have them just surprise you. But I decided I better pick out stuff for him because I kind of know what he might like or might want to be adventurous. Mm-hmm. And you can cancel at any time. I got to check.
It says, thank you for being a part of our healthy snacking community. Because of your order, we were able to provide a healthy snack for a hungry child at school.
Oh, cool.
Through our partnership with Breakfast Club of Canada. Thank you for making this possible, Anita.
Oh, I didn't know that it did
to
that.
To get the most from your Laid Back Snacks experience, follow us on Instagram and Facebook for exclusive offers, tasty recipes, and more. And don't forget to tag us when you share your Laid Back Snacks moments. Thanks for your order, and happy snacking!
All right. So Craig's going to snip all these bags open, and then we will get him to try a little bit from each one.
It's got little things on the bottom, but I don't know what they mean.
Oh, those are that's called social media, Craig. So that's where people, Instagram, Facebook, how you can connect. So Craig's just learning about these things.
I am illiterate.
No, you're not illiterate. You can totally read. It's just
which one
social media.
Try first?
It's up to you. You'll have to, you need to tear it open. Are your hands clean? Wait. Because of COVID land, every time we open up a box from the outside, we should be washing our hands. Ooh, that's... Technically, we should wash our hands from... Because the box came from a delivery person. And nothing personal, but contact. Contact with lots of things. So you don't want to... You want to wash your hands after you touch a box that came from the outside world before you put your hands in your mouth. So we'll be back in a minute.
We are the nuts.
We are the nuts. The knock. No, that's okay,
we are
nuts.
The nuts.
All right, so now you're going to try them.
I'm going to try one, yeah.
Okay, which one are you trying?
Sporadic. Sporadic nut.
No, sriracha.
Cashews.
I want to try one, too.
You want to try one? Let me try one first.
You try it first.
They're stuck together.
What does it look like? Let us see what it looks like. Hold it up in front of the camera. Oh, it's like a cluster, kind of like a, reminds me of Cracker Jacks, except it's spicy and not full of sugar, right? Are they burning? Can you show, can you bring it closer? Can you put it in front of the lens? Want to see what it looks like? Just hold the cluster. Mm-hmm. Just right, can hopefully, I'll just hold it still for a sec. Hopefully it's going to focus.
It's not for Anita.
It's burning hot, but they're like clustered. Okay, it's all like sriracha chili pepper. Mm-hmm. Okay, on a 0, 1 to 10, on your burn scale, how much heat are you getting right now from the sriracha cashews?
1 to 10.
1 to 10. And can I tell the viewers out there in internet land that what I wasn't eating because it quit. So this has tamari sauce and some natural sugars in it. So let's get trying. This
is called sea salt.
Called Sunday cashews. So it's a sweet salty.
Soy.
Like a soy sauce. Another Asian-y kind of. Called Sunday cashews. Looks good to me. I love cashews. That's one of my favorite. Okay, what do you think? Tamari-like? There is tamari in this. Looks good. You know, it's very healthy. First of all, I've been working on UV resin stuff over there, so just ignore that. We don't eat that, of course. Mm. You good? Can I have some, please? I'm actually getting hungry. Yeah.
Well, I think you're working. It's actually quite good.
Can you show? Oh, they look very plumped up. They look very, very plump.
And they've got that tamari stuff in it again. And
they're kind of like clustered.
Tamari, you'll like it. It's got
okay, put it in my mouth. Drop it in.
That's kind of nice. Nice, gentle, savory, delicious. Some
sesame seeds on them. Oh, like, reminded me of like soy sauce or teriyaki.
Soy, yeah.
For me, I think it's a little bit too much coating.
Evaporated cane juice, tamari sauce, whole soybeans, wheat, sea salt,
sesame. Oh, soybeans.
Oh, you're right, with sesame seeds. Sea salt, rice vinegar, and natural flavor.
I think it's a little too sweet, actually, for me, but not bad. It's still good. A little too sweet, though.
Best before July 15th, so I guess I have to eat them
all. Also, all the dates are different, so you have to go by the dates and eat those ones first.
I'll have to eat
nuts, them. Definitely. If you get nuts, we like to store them, if Craig listens to me, in the freezer or fridge, because they anything with nuts or oils like that, to preserve them longer. But I see some of these things expire differently depending what's in them, I guess. All right, so what's your favorite out of all these five? Actually, that has a nice aftertaste.
I sort of like this one.
Yeah, that one's good, but then you like sugar.
Yeah.
And it is a natural, like a cane sugar, so that's good.
And I like the
tamari.
Tamari.
That's my favorite. Hearty tamari. Can you hold up all the bags? Because I didn't get a shot.
I like those ones.
Oops, I'm losing my camera.
So far, these are my favorites.
All right. Protein, power up, sriracha, cashews to get the burn, and hearty tamari. Oh, he likes that one too. Sunday cashews. All right.
The whole flavor is too crunchy for my teeth in the back. And,
I want to share
it. It is pretty spicy, hot.
It's probably like, like a nibble.
If you like hot mustard, it's kind of like when I was in my friend's house in Surrey.
Mm-hmm.
And we had raw fish. He said, eat it with hot mustard. And hot mustard flavor.
Oh, okay. I'm not a fan of hot mustard. So, again, heartburn for me anyway. All right. Well, thank you, Craig.
I'm not really a hot mustard fan.
Thank you. And now part two of your birthday present will be another thing in the mail. Because, hey, in these times of not allowed to go out, not allowed to shop here, there, or anywhere, why not have fun things come to you in the mail? Yeah. So there's another one coming, but I'm not telling you what it is. And we'll do a video when that one comes, and it's from a different company. Oh. Another snack one. Okay, say bye to your
fans.
All right. Okay, so I just realized that Craig opened up the box, right, which came from the outside world, and this day of you know, that virus thing. He then touched all the bags. So he went and washed his hands, but now he's going to touch the bags again and then eat them. So now we've got to actually disinfect these packages because he should have opened the box, washed his hands, then maybe touched them. So this is a good, you got to just mist and then wipe.
Okay.
No, in the back. No, like the back and front, you know?
Yeah, the back.
No, like all over, lightly, far away.
It is.
What do you want for the top?
Staining everything. It's eating right.
You got to wipe it off right away.
It's eating right through
the
back. You
should be wiping it off right away. That's why I gave you a cloth.
Oh.
And so the person came with the pizza and, had their mask was not, they actually touched it to move it up onto their nose and said, oh, sorry, and then proceeded to hand him the pizza. So I'm like, oh no, the box, like it's, when you touch your mask, it's the same as touching your face without a mask because the particles and breath go through the masks. Unless you're wearing an N95 or a ventilator, respirator thing. So we had to like disinfect. It's a pain, but I don't want to take a chance in getting that silly old bug that's controlling our entire world now for over a year.
Oh, yeah,
take it seriously.
Yeah.
In theory, I mean, so I'm gonna clean off. So it's a pain, I know, but it's worth being clean and doing everything we can. Obviously, we can't stop that bug. They're censoring a lot of YouTube videos, so I don't want to use all the words that I would normally use to describe COVID 19 and all the variants now that are out there. So Craig's just cleaning
there
and all the packages, and now he can enjoy them.
Okay. We are the nuts.
We are the nuts. The knock. Oh, that's
we are the nuts.
All right, so now you're going to try them.
Now I'm going to try one, yeah.
Okay, which one are you trying?
Sporadic. Sporadic nut.
No, sriracha.
Sriracha.
Cashews. I want to try one, too.
You want to try one? Let me try one first.
You try it first.
Well, they're stuck together.
What does it look like? Let us see what it looks like. Hold it up in front of the camera. Oh, it's like a cluster, kind of like a... reminds me of Cracker Jacks, except it's spicy and not full of sugar, right? Are they burning? Can you show? Can you bring it closer? Can you put it in front of the lens? Want to see what it looks like? Just hold the cluster.
Mm-hmm.
Just right. Can hopefully, I'll just hold it still for a sec. Hopefully, it's going to focus.
It's not for Anita.
It's burning hot, but they're like clustered. Okay, it's all like sriracha, chili pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, on a 0, 1 to 10 on your burn scale. How much heat are you getting right now from the sriracha cashews?
1 to 10.
1 to 10. And can I tell the viewers out there in internet land that what I wasn't thinking when I bought you crunchy hard snacks?
Wow.
The That's dilemma?
Right up there about, and I only had one. I'd say it's about an 8.
An 8, okay. And can I tell them the thoughtless thing your wife did in buying you crunchy, hard, nutty snacks? The dilemma?
Oh, yeah.
That I totally forgot. Poor Craig. And this is a good note for young people and everyone to take care of their teeth. He takes care of his teeth in the last 30 years or so. But because of damage done way back and fillings, he has lost how many teeth in the last... Tamari. Now, Tamari, I've heard of that name. Read on the back. Is it just... It's just cashews, right? Is it tamari seasoning?
Quite a list of
ingredients. Yeah, for the spice part.
It's one of our most popular savory snacks. It's a fantastic healthy alternative to those no good potato chips. Instead of empty calories,
I'll take the potato chips without salt.
Instead of empty calories, hard tamari will leave you feeling happy and satiated.
Okay, what's the ingredient list though?
Sesame sticks and spicy pretzels mixed with almonds and cashews. All lovingly slow roasted to in delicious tamari. This exotic taste from Japan confirms
Japan.
What we already knew. For good times, make them tamari time. Tamari.
Tamari.
And then it tells you what's in there.
Okay, well, let's get to tasting.
Roasted almonds, dry roasted cashews, pretzel sticks, grain.
So pretzel sticks and
bran.
Sesame stick. Oat bran.
That's
wow, that really is healthy.
It's too healthy. It's too healthy, man. Okay, so what I got in here is like
Okay, you try first.
I got some cashews and almonds.
Here, hold it in your hand. Can you hold it in your hand? Can you hold it in your hand? Got some almonds.
Almonds and
okay, that's all you're eating is the almonds.
Well, I mean,
the other thing. Oh, no, that's all almonds. So try something else in that package, Greg.
That's tasty, yeah.
I'd like to try some.
You want to try some?
I've never had tamari anything. So tamari is a Japanese seasoning.
You like tamari.
Is it sweet and salty?
Yeah, it's nice.
Okay, hold it in your hand because I can't really focus on our galaxy table.
All
right, okay. Lift up a bit. Up a bit. Up top.
I've got pretzel sticks. And,
pretzel sticks, sesame sticks. I'll take a sesame.
It's got whatever that is.
Sesame stick.
That's a sesame stick. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Tamari. That was good.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever tamari is, tastes good. Can I have some more? Can I have a cashew? I love cashews.
Okay,
so I'll take the tamari so far.
You will.
Since I got to eat the sriracha.
Mmm.
Mmm. Good, excuse me. While I eat and talk.
They already said something about this. You're gonna...
Alright. So that's good. So that's tamari.
Well, better than...
What's their number one snack?
It's one of our most popular savory snacks.
Mmm.
Oh, I can see why.
Yeah, I like that.
Quite tasty.
Then we've got... Okay, let's put that away.
And healthy, too.
Put it behind.
Because we fixed the pack.
Weekend crunch.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good. They've got good old Ziploc bags. I've been watching a lot of Nerdy Crafter. Oops, another one. Thank you. Nerdy Crafter videos. Jackie, fellow Canadian, lives in my homeland of Quebec where I was born, but too young to remember it. I know I've been watching a lot of her videos lately, and she really has a thing about Ziploc bags and like craft kits. Things that you can reclose and reseal, so she'd be happy. And she's actually the one I first watched ever do any kind of snack kits, but they were all from like Japan, which I've never tried. But this time, Craig's birthday is coming up in April. And I thought, hey, let's get some subscription stuff for fun.
They're looking for a tasty alternative to nutrient-free potato chips.
Okay, what's in the ingredients?
Roasted peas.
Okay, roasted peas. How about you put a handful in your hand and show the fine people out there.
Sugars, wasabi peas, green peas.
Oh, they are wasabi peas. Okay.
Starch, rice flour.
Can you put some in your hand?
Cane sugar, palm oil.
I don't know if I can handle wasabi peas because I can't handle spicy foods. I wasn't sure if they'd be wasabi because I've had non-wasabi peas and I love the peas. But I can't handle the wasabis.
Okay, see that?
Okay, lift up a bit. Okay, so there's wasabi peas. Hominy? Is that hominy? And what's barley? What is that white stuff?
I don't know.
Okay, I'm gonna live on the edge and try a wasabi pea because or one of those. It looks like hominy.
You wouldn't like that.
What is it?
It's a hot pepper. Hot mustard.
I guess I won't be having anything. Like that, because I'll have heartburn and whine about it for hours. Do you have a favorite snack yet?
Well, so far I like the...
Tamari?
The tamari one, yeah. That's
yeah.
This one is...
Those wasabi peas, though. Oh, man.
This one is...
Right, so what's your favorite out of all these five? Actually, that has a nice aftertaste.
I sort of like this one.
Yeah, that one's good, but then you like sugar.
Yeah.
And it is a natural, like a cane sugar, so that's good.
And I like the...
Tamari.
Tamari is good.
That's my favorite. Hearty tamari. Can you hold up all the bags? Because I didn't get a shot.
I like those ones.
Oops, I'm losing my camera.
So far, these are my favorites.
All right. Protein, power up, sriracha, cashews to get the burn, and hearty tamari.
Wonderful.
Oh, he likes that one too. Sunday cashews. All right.
It's okay, but it's too crunchy for my teeth in the back. And,
I want to share it with
my... It is pretty spicy hot.
It could probably be just like a nibble.
If you like hot mustard, it's kind of like when I was in my friend's house in Surrey. Mm-hmm. And we had raw fish. He said, eat it with hot mustard. And hot mustard flavors.
Oh, okay. Not a fan of hot mustard. So, again, heartburn for me anyway. All right. Well, thank you, Craig.
I'm not really a hot mustard fan.
Thank you. And now part two of your birthday present will be another thing in the mail. Because, hey, in these times of not allowed to go out, not allowed to shop here, there, or anywhere, why not have fun things come to you in the mail? Yeah. So there's another one coming, but I'm not telling you what it is. And we'll do a video when that one comes. And it's from a different company. Oh. Another snack one. Okay. Say bye to your fans. All right.
Well, if you hung out till the end, I hope you found this a little entertaining, a little enlightening. Please remember that none of this is sponsored or anything like that. We did discover, originally I got this on the Laid Back website, but it turns out they do sell these products at well.ca, and so therefore I'm guessing they may sell them at other locations as well. You don't have to go to Laid Back necessarily. But I compared the prices, and they're pretty equivalent. So it was worth it, and it's fun to get snack boxes, especially, like we've been saying, during times like these lovely pandemic times that originally were going to last, what, a couple of weeks, a month, 6 months tops, and here we are into it way over a year. So it's fun to do whatever it takes to, I don't know, just bring a smile into someone's face, make it gifted to somebody. There's tons you can choose from on the internet. I would definitely recommend these ones. We both went. It was good quality, and they're Canadian, and they look, they don't have a bunch of chemicals or anything like that. All right, so stay tuned for the next one. It's a total different, turnaround. And if you want to connect with us, we're at www.walkingwayoverrated.blogspot.com. is where our life vlogs and such articles are posted. And for creativity, it's heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. And then I also have an Etsy shop, aburgycreation.etsy.com. And if you, Aburgy Creation is the umbrella of everything else that goes underneath that, because we're Aburgies, so we call everything Aburgy Creation. All right, hope you have a great week. And stay safe, guys.